Hey everybody, it's Jazzy Horse Girl 101, and today I'm gonna be giving you guys a tutorial on how to make a stalemate barn. This video has been requested by a lot of you, and I finally got around to doing it, so yeah. I hope you guys enjoy, and this is going to be a basic four stall barn, and it's going to have sliding doors, halter hooks, and yeah, it's gonna be pretty basic, but it's gonna look really cool once you're done. It's love with hands and feet. I wanna find my own way to reach a world in need. Yeah. Here's my box. My box in particular is about 11 and a half by a little over 10 and a half. 10 and I don't know measurements. I kind of suck at that. I already cut out some pieces, but don't worry, I will show you what I did. So, this was here. And then I just... You want to measure to the middle of your box, depending on what shoebox you have. Actually, it has the measurements over there. Look at that! How handy is that? 12 inches by 11 and a half. Well, that's not 12. I don't know what 12 they're getting from, but... You can see I actually have a mark from where I measured to the middle. And then you're going to figure out how big you want your aisleway to be. I have this old barn over here that I'm actually getting rid of, but it has a bunch of sawdust in it. But you can see how the aisleway is all wonky, it's too small, you can't do anything, and it's just terrible. Like, this is a terrible barn. You do not want to build a barn like this. It's awful. But yeah, because I didn't measure anything in that, I just kind of threw it all together. I mean, you can do that, it's up to you, but measurements always make it look nicer and neater and prettier. This is going to have pretty rectangular-ish stalls, and they're not going to be super big, because this is the length, and then the width is going to be to the middle. You cut out your aisleway, which my aisleway was 3 inches in total, and it was right in the middle, as you can see. So you're going to set this piece aside because you can use it to make a door. If you don't want a door, just get rid of it. But you can make a sliding door if you so choose. I actually probably won't make a door, so I'm just going to get rid of this. And what you're going to want to do is figure out, do you want windows? My barn is going to have windows. I already did two in the front. You can see the pieces here that I cut out. So again, you're going to want to measure to the middle. As you can see, I have little marks from where I measured to the middle, from your aisleway to the end of your barn. And then you're going to want to figure out how big you want yours to be. My window is 1.5 by 1.5. And I did 1.5 from the bottom because that is a good stalemate height for windows, as you can see. They can still, like, you know, look out of it. You can see there's a bunch of different stalemates. They all can look out the windows. It's great. For the tall ones, it's gonna look a little weird, so plan out your barn from what you want, like which horse you want it to be in, because someone like this girl, it doesn't look as good with her, because it looks like it's down too far and doesn't look as pretty. So if you want to do something with a taller stalemate, make sure you raise the window up. If that makes any sense. Windows so far, and if you want to know exactly how I make a window, I'm going to do two over here and then two on the other side, and that actually opens up your barn more and makes it look more spacious if you add windows, so I do recommend doing that. 1.5 from the bottom. So you're going to take your ruler and you're just going to measure up 1.5, and you're just going to draw a line kind of. I'm going all the way across because I have an eraser and I can just erase what I'm not using. Whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Like I said, this is kind of difficult to work with, but here is your lines that you have nicely measured out. And like I said, that's why I'm using pencil, because I can get rid of those lines. And if you use pen, then you're kind of screwed. So then you're gonna take your X-Acto knife. And be very careful, because they're sharp. So if you are at an age where you have to ask your parents to use an X-Acto knife, make sure that you ask them and you make sure that they watch you, or they can cut it out for you. Well, that's even better. Have them cut it out for you. So yes, be careful with this. It is very, very sharp. All we always be careful of where your fingers are. That's all I gotta say. Tell your parents to be careful where their fingers are before cutting it out for you. See, there I had a mistake. That can't really be covered up, so whoops. There is my second window. Yay! I made a little oopsie there with the X-Acto knife. Luckily, it wasn't a finger oopsie. It was just going outside the line oopsie. But what you can do to fix that is you can just cover your entire barn with popsicle sticks, like I have done with this barn here. As you can see, completely coated in popsicle sticks, which actually makes you not have to be as careful. And if you do make mistakes, it covers that up. But I'm not going to cover this with popsicle sticks because I just don't want to. So I'm going to cut out the windows on that side, and then we'll go and start the inside. As I've mentioned before, popsicle sticks are like your barn building best friend, other than cardboard. If you have those two things, you can pretty much make anything. But as you can see, I have lined this window with popsicle sticks, and you can see compared to the other window, it looks 10 times better. It looks more clean, more realistic. I also covered the wording with paper to make it look a little nicer too. And then I also lined the doorway with some popsicle sticks. You can do that however you want. This is just what I did personally. I still haven't decided if I'm putting a door on it or not, but yeah. And then inside the window, you can do toothpicks for bars. They look the best for stalemates if you do toothpicks. You can line all of your windows or just the front. For right now, I'm just doing the front. I can always line the other ones later. So I'm gonna line this one just to show you kind of how I do it. I'm gonna find a straight popsicle stick. Sometimes they can be bent and curvy. You don't want that because then it won't fit right and it will look stupid. I cut off the rounded edge like so. Make it as straight as possible. It doesn't have to be perfect unless you want it to be. What you're gonna do is you're gonna figure out the length of your window. You wanna go measure it so that you can have a popsicle stick next to it, and like it all lines up nice like that, if you can see. So like you want to do the length of your window plus an extra width of a popsicle, and then you're going to want to cut out four of these. So you're just going to use this as like a pattern, and you're just going to cut them out, because since my window is square, all the popsicle stick should be the same length since it's a square, because that's the definition of a square. If it wasn't, it would be a rectangle. Sticks can kind of go flying, so make sure you're not near people, because you might hit them in the eyeball with a piece of popsicle stick. Anywho, so I have my pieces here, and what you're going to want to do is take your hot glue gun, apply some glue. And then glue them on. Yep, and then that's all you gotta do. And then if you have some cardboard sticking out inside the window, you can take your X-Acto knife and just kinda shave it off. And there you have it. You've got a nice nice looking front. There we go. And I'm going to do mine completely out of popsicle sticks. You can use cardboard. Cardboard is easier to work with and doesn't take as long, but I'm going to be using popsicle sticks. So I haven't really decided how I'm going to do this. Probably should have did that before I did a video. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take your box and find the middle again. So I have found the middle of this side and that side, and I put glue two popsicle sticks to them, to the sides, so that I have a base to start off of. Now, I'm going to do the dividers first, so I need to figure out, we're gonna match it with this length, or even, so we're gonna like, I can't talk. So, you're gonna cut a bunch of popsicle sticks to this length, making sure you get rid of the rounded edges. Sorry for the break in steps, but I had to figure out what I was doing. So what you're gonna make is this. And how you make this is you're gonna get a single popsicle stick that's straight, and you're just gonna wanna cut out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 popsicle sticks that are the same length as you want your stall to be. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take this piece and we're gonna glue it to this piece in here, and that doesn't stand up, but you get the gist. And then that's your divider. So you're just gonna make this, like I said, and you're gonna make two of them because, you know, four stalls, two dividers. Alright, so once you got your two pieces made, you're just gonna glue them in to your barn here, just like that. You can see it's a nice size for your horse. I actually might, I don't know if this would look better with an extra. Yeah, I think that looks better. So I'm gonna add an extra popsicle stick there. So I think that looks better than having it wide open like that. So, alright, so once you get your dividers in, you have to plan out what you're doing as your walls for the front of your barn, or for, like, I guess, I don't know what to call that, but not your dividers, but just your, I don't know. Anywho, so this is what I have, and this is what I'm going to show you guys how to do. I just built this entire stall just so I could figure out what I was doing before I would explain anything, because I did not make any plans for this barn. I just kind of winging it. So as you can see, I added some toothpicks in the divider for just to make it look cooler and whatnot. So yeah, there's little toothpicks for like bars, and then I also finished this front part, and then my sliding door here, as you can see, that's what it looks like. I also added a little hook here with some wire for the halter and lead rope to hang, and then I also added bars on the front here, and I did not add bars. I'm gonna add bars here then too, but yeah, so this is what your finished stall is going to look like. Started building up over here, as you can see. Just, you know, I was just planning it out, but I'm going to show you what I did on this other side. So the first thing you need to do is figure out how wide you want your door to be. My doorway is about 1.5 inches wide. I feel like that's a decent sized doorway for the Stablemates. It's a little on the smallish side. I sometimes make them bigger. Like for this barn in particular, I think it's a little bigger than 1.5, but I'm not entirely sure. I did not measure that barn, but anyway, so once you figure out how wide you want your doorway to be, you're gonna make sure that you place your doorway so that when you slide your door open, it's not hanging out in your doorway, if that makes any sense. So like, you don't want your door to be stuck here and can't slide over any farther, because then it's pointless. So as you can see, mine still hangs in the doorway a little bit, just because I didn't do a very good job of measuring. But I think it's good enough that it's not too bad. So yeah, so what you want to do is you're just going to want to figure out, okay, so how far away from this wall can my door slide open and still be in the right spot. So, alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out 9 of these pieces, and these pieces are about 2 inches long. I held them up to my ruler and I figured that out. Other size you're going to need is this, and this is basically just cutting out off the rounded edges, because you're gonna wanna make it as tall as this is right here, your board for your divider, so that they line up and match at the same height. So you're going to want two of these pieces. Then you want to take those 9 pieces that you cut out and you're going to glue them like this to one of your long pieces that you cut out, just like this. And then this is going to be the start of your wall on this side, so it's going to look like that. So you can go ahead and you can glue that in. I usually glue this side and then the bottom and then I just shove it in. So you can do that then. So you'll glue that in as straight as you can. I'm not too worried about straightness because I'm just kind of throwing this barn together just to show you guys how to make a barn. So I'm not super concerned with everything. So if this is your first stall, it doesn't really matter, but I like to make sure, like if it's your second stall, I like to make sure all my doorways are staying the same size. If my divider was a little crooked, that kind of keeps it looking better if you just make sure the doors are the same size. So I double checked and my lengths are matching up at least a little bit. So next you're going to want to work on this part, and since this is the side where the divider is kind of different lengths, like on this side it doesn't really matter, so you can build kind of like you did over here, but since it's the lengths are going to be different, I'm going to actually just do 5 popsicle sticks attached before I glue the thing in, and then I'll go up from there. So kind of like this side, as you can see, I only had a few in before I glued it in. In this case I only had 3, but you can do 5 since there's 5 popsicle sticks that are the same, make it the same length. So just repeat, because you have your other popsicle stick that's this size, so you're just going to glue 5 pieces that are about this length, and this length is about 1.5. That's about how long this piece is. So I can see I have 5 popsicle sticks, and that's just going to glue in right there. So you can go ahead and glue that in, and then you're just going to take a popsicle stick, cut off the round piece, and then just kind of measure out the exact distance that you need to match it up with your divider. So that's what I'm going to do, and then you just finish it up, go all the way up until, and you go like completely all the way up. So you're not going to stop at 9, there's like, you're going to do 9, you're going to do 11 instead of 9, like on this side. And I'll show you why in a second. Okay, so once you have your popsicle sticks building up all the way to the top, you're going to put 2 long popsicle sticks. See how I left a little bit of space so then I could put these 2 in, so that makes your doorway. And I just left 2 popsicle sticks about at the top. I might have cut this a little bit, but that's about what it is. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to make this door. And as you can see, I did them sliding on the inside instead of the outside, so that's what we're going to do now. So what you're going to do to make this door is you're going to do 4 popsicle sticks about the size of your doorway. So you have to make sure that when you have it in, that it is the right width of your door, and it's not gonna like be too short and not work. So as you can see, I made it just big enough to fit, and then the border around it is just, yeah, it's pretty simple. And then you're just gonna cut a piece up here, so technically you have 5 of these shorter pieces and then 2 longer pieces that are the same height, a little bit taller than your doorway, but like still a decent size. I can't explain things, I'm sorry. So I had to shorten mine because even though it fit the doorway, it did not fit over here very well. Now it fits a little better, so that my when the door slides open, the horse can still fit through the door. So yeah, there we go. So now what you can do is you can put toothpicks in to be your bars. I do 3. That's usually the general rule, is 3 of them. So just go ahead and do that. And then we'll make the sliders, and then you'll have a stall done. And then you just have to repeat that 3 more times, and then, yeah, you'll have your barn. That you have your toothpicks on your door for your bars. You need to cut out 2 long pieces that are the same, like that they go all the way to the, I don't know how to explain this, that they just leave a little extra past the doorway, as you can see. So you need 2 of these. Then once you have these pieces, you're gonna need 2 supporting pieces that are the same width as your door. So you can use the pieces of popsicle stick that you cut up, and you just need to find 2 that are the same width as your door so that they can support these, so that they can go behind it. And you'll see why in a second. So just find 2 pieces that you can glue to one end of each of these popsicle sticks. Okay, so once you've glued those pieces on, as you can see, just like that, you're going to put your door flat up against your stall front, and then you're just going to glue these so that you're going to put a little glue at the end here and then a little bit on your little tip here, and then you're just going to glue that right over your door so that it can slide back and forth. You're going to put 1 up here and then 1 down on the ground. Alright, so once you have them glued on, your door should slide back and forth just like this. It's hard to do with one hand. So you just want to make sure that it rides smoothly along the track. And if you look from the front, it's getting stuck at the top a little bit, but it still slides. Just not as easily as I want. And you can always fiddle with it. If it's too tight up against the wall, you can redo it. You can take it off, glue it back, and see if it slides better. But yeah, that's basically all you do. And you just do it for all these stalls, and then in the end, you will have a beautiful barn. That's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm sorry it wasn't very informative. I kind of just threw this video together because it was requested, so I'm kind of busy with life right now, so it's hard for me to do videos, but I'm also doing a how-to video on how to do traditional lead ropes, because that was also requested by someone, so stay tuned for that. And as always, to make your bar more realistic, you can add sawdust, as you see I've added to my 2 completed stalls, or you can add buckets for water and food, you can add hay racks, you can add salt licks. Everything will make that your barn look 10 times better if you put in more effort for it. But yep, that's all I'm gonna do. And then you can add hooks, like I added a hook on this door. You can see there's a hook there for halters. And yeah, that's everything. Like I said, you just have to repeat all the steps for each stall, and then you'll have your nice stablemate barn that was sort of kind of planned out but kind of just thrown together. That's the one advice I gotta give you, is always plan out your barns, measure everything. I just threw this together, so it's not as pretty as it could be, but it's definitely better than this one where it's ugly. It's an ugly barn that I'm throwing out as soon as I use up that sawdust. But yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye!